I would like to introduce Shri Bhushan Dewan. Shri Bhushan Dewan is a war veteran of 1971 Indo-Pak War, having doctorate degree in literature from USA and M.Tech from IIT Delhi. He is a former visiting faculty to overseas and Indian universities. He has authored a number of books on technology, entrepreneurship, and management. He's a national vice president of Sarvodaya Bharat Party and has filed nomination for Lok Sabha from South Bombay as a party candidate.
Hearty good evening to all of you. It's a tough task, right? The main speakers have already gone. Highly curtailed version, a bit outdated version. I am no more the candidate for Mumbai South from Sarvodaya Bharat Party. I become wiser after studying some statistics I'll share with you. Another thing, I am D-lit, not really in literature. Another thing, I have been ex-vice president of TCS and senior vice president of Adani Group and Mundra Port. Well, I want to share with you, well, of course, one thing is that, you know, we all know this. Chirag Tale Andhera, right? Nearer the church, farther the God. People in Haridwar never take bath in Ganges, right? We go, and people in Delhi, if you go, 70%, 80% people have not seen Qutub Minar. We'll go to Delhi and see Qutub Minar. What I mean is, as Mehta ji told us, as Dhamija ji told us, we are all talking of democracy. All our political leaders talking of democracy. But do they have democracy in their own party? No. Not at all. Everything is controlled by just one or two people, right? We know that. We shouldn't say which bhais, right? Few bhais, right? Few bhais control everything. And that is not true only about current party. Aam party has failed. You know it. Why? The bossism of one man. All good people had to leave. So what is that? Chirag Tale Andhera. Well, in a lighter way, and you know, they say war is too important a thing to be left to generals. So I think constitution is too important a thing to be left to only constitutional experts. A 4G has also come in, right? So party democracies don't have. Even a local, even a, who's a chief minister? Can I get a BJP ticket? As Mehta Bhai said, can I get a BJP ticket from South Mumbai? I can't. Who decides? Everything is decided by two bhais. So you can imagine the inconsistency, the irony. How can you really spawn democracy if you don't follow it in your own, in your own party? So that is where the USA system has primaries. People are selected right from there, and you can go up. So that is a beautiful part of that system. Second thing, we all talk about democracy. I had the occasion to meet Mr. late Sudarshan, K. Sudarshan, in Bhopal. He was the RSS chief, predecessor to Bhagwat ji. And he said, Professor Dewan, I mean, you think we have democracy just because we have elections? I said, yes. He said, look at the numbers. India's population today, 130 crores. Roughly, voting population, 90 crores. But we don't vote. Now, 29th April is a Monday, right? So Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, long weekend, we go to Goa. How many people vote? About 66%. So 90 crores population, voting population, right? And how many vote? About 60 crores, all right? And next beautiful thing, 60 crores vote. So if there are four candidates in that, in one from BJP, one from Congress, one from Shiv Sena, one from so-and-so, one from guy like me, Sarvodaya Bharat Party, there's a division of votes, correct? I mean, there's a division of votes. And second thing, first past the post. What is first past the post? I have seen, trying to become member of stand for elections in South Mumbai, I saw that Arvind Sawant has won the elections in South Mumbai. And the population is around 15 lakhs. And voters are about 12 lakhs. And out of 12 lakhs, votes polled were about 9 lakhs. And out of that, Sawant has polled 4.2 lakhs, right? So which means what? So if you get about, averagely, I was in Satna, pro-vice chancellor there, and I found that typically 3 to 3.5 lakhs votes if you get, you are MP. This I'm talking of 2014, I studied that. So if you get 4 to 5 lakh votes in a constituency, you are MP. You sit in the Central Hall of Parliament or Lok Sabha, what? So imagine now, 542 MPs into 4 lakhs. But practically 544. So 272 MPs make the winning party, make the ruling party, make the government, right? So 272 into 4 lakhs is roughly how much? 5 lakhs. Let's take it 5 lakhs, just for quick calculation. So how much it is? It's about 13 crores people. 272 divided into 5 lakhs is 13 crores people. So imagine the guy, of course, there's indirect election. Those 272 guys, hypothetically, theoretically, elect their leader, elect Modi or whomsoever they want. I mean, they're not, they don't do election like that. It's just, right, you know how it works. Party bosses decide, RSS decides, or Sonia Gandhi decide. So 13 crores people have only voted for that guy, for that party. Out of 130 crores, that guy who's control leader, who's ahead, only 1/10 out of 130 crores population, he has got a clear yes, clear mandate on only 13 crores people. Is this democracy? Unlike some European governments where you have 50%, unless you get 50% votes, you are not treated as elected. So first pass the post system over here. And last small point, third point, where the whole corruption starts. Like, see, Election Commission, if you know, I studied this, has limited the expenditure for elections not more than 70 lakhs per constituency, 70 lakhs. Practically, expenditure made in a place like Satna, around 10 to 15 CR. In a place like Mumbai, if you have to stand for election, you have to spend at least 25 crores. So, averagely 20 crores per constituency you have to spend to stand if you want to fight elections. So, 70 lakhs is the limit. Let's say 1 crore is the limit. Whereas you're spending how many? Around 15 crores. Which means all this is black money, right? So 15 crores is the black money, right? So 15 crores into 544, say 540, 10,000 crores black money being generated in one election over 2 months, 3 months, 10,000 crores. And what is the black money? If I get 10,000, if I have to spend 10, 20 crores taking money from you, taking money from you, taking money from you, tomorrow, see, we in business, at least 10% profit. So I am generating, out of 10,000 crores money spent, over the next 5 years, at least 1 lakh crore money will be black money. Correct? Underhand money. Why? I have to return that. I have to recover. So look at, is this democracy? So the point is, the system is crying for a desperate change. And Mr. Mehta's book is a beacon in this darkness for us to think. And the only point is, we feel, what can I do? There's a lovely thing in his book, if you have read the last thing. If a seed was to say, then what can I do? Can I be the farm? Farm will never grow. By one seed, only one plant grows. So if the farm has to grow, if every one of us has a right. Everyone has a, not a right, every one of us has a duty. So if we don't take it up, nobody will take it up. So the thing is, when we go back, first thing at least we do is get involved. Get involved in voting. Say your say. Try to educate people. Try to get, you know, then only things will go forward. I'm delighted and honored that I have been given a chance to speak. Thank you very much, Jashwant Bhai. And let's see, we can take it forward. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you, Mr. Dewan, for such a wonderful speech.